two club record transfers, two clubs, two players. Manchester United re-signed Paul Pogba from Juventus and Andre Ayew heads to West Ham from Swansea. We break this all down in this City Sports video. And I have Benjamin Nketsia here with me. Ben, it's finally over. Paul Pogba is back home. 92 million, some say, 89 million, some say. And Andre Ayew, record transfer for West Ham from Swansea. Initial thoughts, are you surprised this Pogba thing has finally been done? Or for you, it was just a matter of when, not if?
Well, I think it's always been a matter of when, because we know that with a deal as complex as this one and as expensive as this one, there will always be middlemen, endorsement deals, advertisements.
Image rights.
Exactly. And if you've been following the trend, you realize that UK rapper Stormzy had something to do with he is good friends with Paul Pogba, both of them sponsored by Adidas. So that was certainly going to be tied in. He actually tweeted the deal before he quickly deleted it on his Twitter handle. So that all went into place. But I mean, it was always going to happen. And I think that United have been planning this for a while, for Jose Mourinho to reunite with what I think is an attempt to build the franchise again around one player. That's what Paul Pogba gives United, really. A franchise cornerstone for the next decade or maybe more.
Let's talk about matters on the pitch now. How is this all going to play out for Manchester United? We've talked a lot about their team and what they need and their potential, and Paul Scholes and Rio Ferdinand have spoken endlessly about the buzz Paul Pogba will provide. But let's get down to a team shape. Where is he going to play? How will he help Manchester United?
Well, simply put, I will not put him in a box. I think that Paul Pogba is a midfield maestro, basically. And he's a complete midfielder. He can tackle, he's strong, he can shoot from distance, he can dribble, and he has the ability to pull the unexpected. I think that that is practically the only reason why you should buy a player for 89 million, a player who can give you the unexpected. And that's what United get in Paul Pogba. It's even more beautiful because he says that it's a journey he started, he felt disrespected.
Yeah,
now
I've listened to that interview. He says that his mom told him that he would come back one day.
The issues of destiny and football.
Destiny and all of that.
And it's always the mothers too.
The mothers have a key role there. But let's move it on to Andre Ayew. Was that a move that surprised you? Because we had heard clubs before he joined Swansea, like Liverpool and Spurs, being interested. And then after the season ended, nobody seemed to make any move. And then West Ham pull out 20 and a half million and get their man.
Well, I just think that West Ham, probably Slaven Bilic, appreciates the evolution of Andre Ayew better than most. And I think that a lot of clubs were eyeing Andre Ayew from a distance and thought that they could, or admitted that he was a quality player, but did not have the guts to spend on him in the manner in which West Ham have gone ahead to do so. I think that this is evidence of the Premiership's new money coming into play. Millennium Stadium, now record signing. It just gives you a sense of where the club wants to go. And Slaven Bilic, I think, is ready to use Andre Ayew in a role different from what we've seen. I mean, Swansea started the process, but I think that Bilic will open up the process to different dimensions. He will do different things, but primarily, we used to have Andre Ayew, the central midfielder and the defensive midfielder. Andre Ayew, the left winger. Now we have Andre Ayew, the center forward.
So has he gone full circle now? So has he gone from midfield to attack? Is he now a full-blown attacker? He scored 12 goals for Swansea last season, albeit all of them really from central positions. I personally think he's going to thrive as a 9.5 or maybe somebody playing behind the front man. Do you think he will be combining with Payet for playmaking duties, or he's been brought in solely to come and score the goals?
Well, I think that for any of us to think that Andre Ayew will simply even walk into this West Ham team just because he's a record signing,
he'll work hard. He has to work hard.
He definitely has to work hard. I mean, I'm looking at the West Ham setup, 5-3-2, sometimes a 4-3-3. Depending on how the manager wants to play, there will be a lot of competition. And there are a lot of players who are similar in his mode. Manuel Lanzini can play as a center forward, can play as an attacking midfielder, and also as a winger. You have Dimitri Payet, attacking midfielder, winger, and also as a center forward. You have guys like Andy Carroll,
Indema, who's certainly a key figure in the West Ham setup,
is not about to lose his place anytime soon just because.
And there's the energy of Mikhail Antonio as well.
Exactly. And he had a breakout season last year, so you expect that he will be allowed to build on that season. But again, I think that the components of the game that Andre Ayew learns as a defensive midfielder, as a central midfielder, and as a winger will not be discarded. It will all come into play in what he will do this season. Because we saw him last season, he did provide some very delicious assists in one of the matches, and he showed that he can pick out the pass. I mean, it's always been his attribute to also create fouls in dangerous situations for his team. He knows how to earn a foul when he's backed into a tight corner. Add that to the fearlessness and the ambition that he showed, and I think that West Ham have themselves a complete player who is still ambitious enough, and I think that the ceiling is still open for Andre Ayew.
So Andre Ayew gets his move to Swansea. He's done the longer route to get to a bigger club, from Marseille to Swansea to West Ham. You see how he fares. He starts off his season, and our first Monday night coverage is Chelsea welcoming West Ham. Andre Ayew getting to play Chelsea for the second straight season on opening day. And for Paul Pogba, will he be part of Man United setup at Bournemouth on the 14th of August? We wait to see. But like I said earlier, two players, two record transfers, two teams, one league, one station. City 97.3. We've got the Premier League on lock. Join us.